Hello everyone, I am Ronak and today I am going to do a preview of this wonderful two-player dueling card game which frankly I cannot stop playing, which is called Rift Force by One More Time Games. In this game, players control a group of summoners and the aim of the game is to get 12 Rift Force, and at the end of that round, whoever has the most Rift Force wins the game. Now, in the beginning of the game, place these 5 cards in the center of the table and each player takes all the cards which are relating to their summoners, shuffle them nicely and make a nice deck and pick up or draw 7 cards at the beginning of the game. Whoever is the second player also gets to just pick up the top card from their deck and place it in the center location as a starting at the beginning of the game. In their turn, players can do 1 out of 3 actions. The first action that they can do is called play. Now in play, players may choose to play up to 3 cards from their hands. Now these 3 cards can be either 3 cards of the same number or they can also be three cards of the same elemental type. In this case, let's say that I choose these 3 5s to play. Whenever I choose which cards to play, I may either choose them to play all in one location or I may choose to play them all in 3 different locations. Just make sure that these 3 locations are adjacent to each other. Now in your turn, if you already have some elementals placed down, you may also choose to activate these elementals and deal damage to your opponent's elementals. Now each elemental also has a health which is directly correlated to the number which is written on the card. For example, this ice elemental right now has 5 health. Now in my turn, if I want to activate my elemental cards, what I have to do is I have to discard a card from my hand which is either matching the same number or matching the same elemental type of that the cards which I'm activating. Now in this case I'm discarding a 7 of crystal and I'll place it over here and I'll activate each of these crystal cards. Now the crystal summoner says that it to place 4 damage on the first elemental in this location, which means that in my turn I will be activating this and I'll be placing 4 damage. Now as a result of activation, if I match the number on the card, I destroy this elemental and this elemental instantly goes into the discard pile of the opponent, and for each elemental that I destroy in my turn, I gain 1 Rift Force. Destroying elementals is kind of the major way to gain Rift Force in the game. Now, the third action which I can do is if I have less card and that will happen in the game where I want to activate more and more cards or place more and more cards, I do the third option which is called check and draw. Now, in check and draw, players first check in which locations do they have some elementals but the opponent has no elementals over there. In that case, for each such location, the active player gains 1 Rift Force. Immediately, I get to draw back up to 7 cards. So that is the check and draw action over here. So I pick up 7 cards in my hand and then I'm ready for the next turn. In this game, that is how players go back and forth and gain Rift Force until a player reaches 12. This game actually is a short game and it is an ideal choice for me because most of the time I'm playing with my wife or I'm playing with my friends and the box is also small enough that I can carry anywhere. One of the things which I really like about this game is that how easily and how short this game is, but it gives that punch in that much time. The game box says around 30 minutes and it roughly finishes in that much time, although some games might go be a little more thinky than the other games. It might, you know, take a lot of time over there. However, what I really love is it's based on one of my favorite themes. It's basically magic and sorcerers dueling it out with each other. The theme is somewhere a lot on point, where there is a shadow faction which does not deal a lot of damage, but it's a very good finishing faction. but there are also some crystals which are oddly balanced for some reason. I like that they are overpowered, but they also have some other balancing factor which keeps them really grounded. The artwork in the game is superb, as you can see that they have made sure that the artwork is, I really love the elemental artwork as well as the summoner, as well as this Rift 4 artwork. It's very clear, you don't have to keep referring to the rulebook again and again. So that is why it's one of my favorite games. And when it comes to replayability, these summoner cards always get shuffled. Plus there are these two more summoner cards and there are these and matching elemental decks along, which come along with it. So I am really looking forward to, if one more time games comes up with some new expansion packs, I'm really looking forward to those new factions if there are any there. Overall, Rift Force gets a very good rating from all of my members of the group, and it's an all-time hit because our member really likes dueling games. If you are somebody who really likes other games which are two player and has a good back and forth, I would recommend Rift Force for you. If you are still wondering, or if you haven't played this genre before, I would suggest give it a go and see if Rift Force works for you. I hope you like this preview of Rift Force. Rift Force is made by One More Time Games, who also has sponsored this video. If you want to check out more about Rift Force and other games which One More Time Games have come up with, I'll leave a link of their website in the description. If you want to see more such preview videos as well as how to play videos, I recommend that you subscribe to my channel Giant Games. Also follow me on Twitter, Instagram and Facebook. Over there, I repeatedly keep announcing my new videos as well as just keep the conversation going about board games. Till then, keep playing and I'll see you in the next one. Bye bye.